I'm gonna be honest. I'm exhausted and I really don't want to practice today, but I have to. Let's talk about it. Hey violinists, Brian here with Let's Talk Violin, a channel where we make violin playing as easy, simple, and fun as possible. So if this is your first time checking out our channel, give us a like and a subscribe so we can keep bringing you awesome new content. So today is my second day out of my 3-day preparation for this upcoming orchestral audition. And unfortunately, today is a day where practicing is just not gonna happen. So I have about 1.5 hours today to get some really good practice done. So I'm going to have to really plan out exactly how I work to get the most bang for my buck. So today is also going to be a struggle because I kind of woke up on the wrong side of the bed and my muscles are really, really sore today. I think I might have overdone the practicing yesterday. It's the kind of work that was necessary, but once in a while, one just ends up getting a little sore. And in a normal world, I would tell myself, don't practice today. If something ever hurts, that's your body telling you that it needs a rest. However, I don't actually have that time, so I'm going to have to intersperse my practicing with a lot more stretches today. I don't think I could overstate how important stretching is when one is practicing. I am the first person to forget to do it. However, it is absolutely crucial to build in stretching time while you work so that your muscles stay loose and limber and you avoid injury. And on top of the physical discomfort I'm feeling today, I'm also feeling a bit of mental discomfort. I had to stay up really late last night doing some work and now I'm really tired. So that means I'm going to have to really do everything that I can to stay focused today. And my way of dealing with that is to do much shorter spurts of practicing. So even though I only have 1.5 hours to practice today, I'm going to split that up into 10-minute chunks. So after every 10 minutes of practicing, I'm going to take a 1-minute stretch break just to give my muscles and my mind a second to recover. It's very interesting. Sometimes even after a 1-minute break, the violin feels completely different when you come back to it. It can feel fresher, it can feel newer, and for some reason, we sometimes notice things that we wouldn't have noticed before had we not taken a break. Whether or not you're preparing for an audition, I would say this is a really important trait to build into your practicing. Adding breaks in between sessions when you can feel your body and your mind getting tired so that you can reset everything. And how long you're able to practice before you need a break is totally up to you. That's very individual and it can honestly change every day. So it's really about listening to your body and knowing what you need. All right, so I have to cover 4 excerpts, a Mozart concerto, and a movement of Bach today. So I'm going to have to actually skip a few steps. So yesterday, day 1, was my day where I, you know, put in all of my fingerings, put in all of my bowings. I worked really slowly and kind of mapped out what I was going to do. Today is going to be get everything up to tempo day. And normally the way I do that is with a metronome. So I would take an excerpt and I would, you know, start it at about half tempo. So if I'm playing at 120 beats per minute for a performance, I would slow it down to about 60 beats per minute. So today what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my excerpts, start them at half tempo, and then increase them 10 beats per minute each time. And I'm really going to try to make sure that they're super clean, super in tune, and really comfortable. You can actually check out some of my practice videos from day 1 on our Instagram page, at Let's Talk Violin, where I practiced the Mozart Symphony No. 39 excerpt really slowly for bow mapping practice and also with a drone. And I put some subtitles with it so you can see my thought process as I work. So I want to tell you a little bit about the room in which I'm practicing. It's a very small, cozy little bedroom. And you may notice the sound in here is really, really dry. To me, that's a really good thing because I want the room to sound as bad as possible when I'm practicing for something important. A dry room like this one is going to give me the most honest feedback for how I actually sound. If I was practicing out in the living room, for example, where there's beautiful resonance, the room might cover up some of the mistakes that I'm actually making. So you might say this is like a little masochistic. However, I think it's actually really good for my mental state in general, because whenever I head into a room that sounds better, I'm going to be that much more inspired and I'm going to feel that much more confident in what I'm creating. That's not to say, though, that there are no drawbacks to practicing in a room like this. There's a few things that one must keep in mind when practicing in a really dry space. One challenge is to try to actually play as if one is in a larger space. So imagining that we are in a cathedral or a concert hall and using enough bow that we're able to create that resonance in this small room. Another challenge in a room like this is that musical ideas tend to become very microscopic and small, and I need to actually exaggerate all of my musical ideas. When I was listening to my practice recordings from yesterday, I was noticing simple things such as the time that I thought I was taking was not coming through on camera whatsoever. Other differences, such as differences in dynamics from piano to forte, they were not coming through at all either. So that made me realize that I need to play my fortes larger, but I also need to play my pianos a lot smaller. So that's going to be my challenge for today. While I'm building up everything with a metronome, I'm going to be doing everything that I can to magnify my musical ideas, because I want them to come through as crystal clear to the judges on the panel. Now, as one is preparing for an audition that's coming up so soon, I think it's really important to set small goals for oneself. So today, my goal is to get everything up to the tempo that I want to perform it at. And the goal for tomorrow is that I'm going to do a mock audition for my fiance, Ronnie, and her family. During this mock audition, I'm going to ask them to call out what I'm supposed to play. So they will ask for my concerto, they will ask for my Bach, and then they will choose the excerpts in the order that I should play them. And the idea is that I shouldn't know what's coming. Usually with auditions, they will ask you what you would like to start with, but I can't bank on that for this. So I'm going to let them choose exactly what I'm supposed to do. It's really hard to step out of one's comfort zone and purposefully make oneself nervous, especially for people that they care a lot about. However, I think this is going to be the best way to get into the proper mindset. So I'm going to go ahead and get to work because I actually have very little time to practice today. But go ahead and check out my posts on our Instagram page so you can track my progress and to see what I'm working on as I'm practicing. All right, let's do this. I'm Brian from Let's Talk Violin. Keep calm and play on, and I'll see you in the next video.